I try to give it a little run here. It's like impossible.
Okay, so there we have it, guys. The 2020 Vmax 1700. It has, let's start with the brakes. It has dual six pot calipers on, I think, our 345 wave rotors, millimeter wave rotors. Very good stopping power. And the rear is a single pot on wave rotors in the back. It's got quad pipes in the back, four outlets. Has a 200 rear tire. Has a little duckbill fin here. And I think I showed in the video on how to open up the gas tank. There's a little lever here. You pop it forward, and then that pops open, and you can get to the fuel. It has dual information centers. It's got the one up top. It has a speedometer and ABS light, oil, fuel light, a shift light that you can program the RPMs, and if you want to do a staging light off the line to hold the RPM, it'll do that for you too. All you can program it all through here, the second information panel. I can see on my phone it's making a weird thing there. That doesn't happen when you're looking at it. It has the time, has a gear indicator, fuel gauge, temperature gauge, also what else does it have? You can change all those settings, like I said, for the shift light and stuff with these two buttons here. One they call select, the other one they call reset. It's very complicated. There's a guy that also has a 2020 Vmax, I think, that gives you a lot more information on how to do this. So I don't want to wreck it for him. Check him out on his channel. I'll try to put that in the link on my on the video. You got your horn, turn signals, brights, hazards. The mirrors work very well. I think I said that in the video. Everything is blacked out. This bike is pretty easy to maintain as far as cleaning, because there's really not much chrome. There's only like the only chrome on this whole bike is the heads are kind of shiny on the bolts, and also back in here there's a little piece of chrome around the intake, like plastic chrome. And it's not that hard to keep clean. That's one of the reasons why I chose this bike over the V-Rod. This thing has an aftermarket fly screen. It better be, because it already has a little bit of corrosion here. It's not that old. It's only a couple. Well, we got it back in September. This is now January, so it hasn't been that long. The headlight works okay. It's a regular standard. It's a standard, you know, halogen bulb right there, and what the rest of the bulbs, I believe, are also halogen. I think the rear is LED though. Let's check. It looks like it's LED. Let's see. Turn the key on. Yeah, the tail light is LED, but the turn signals are standard bulbs, which is okay. I don't really care about that myself. Everything on this bike is factory, except for the phone mount and the fly screen, I believe. Yeah, I just wanted to add that it does have a steering lock. You just turn the steering wheel all the way, and it's locked. It actually works really good. It's a lot easier to use than on my ZX14, where you got to get it exactly in position. This one doesn't seem to be as particular, as long as the steering wheel is fully cocked. There's a better view of the shaft drive. It looks pretty cool. It has some, and here's the adjustment for, this one I think is the preload, and the other side is the compression dampening. Yep, it is. That's a compression dampening. I mean, that's a dampening right there. The other side is preload. Over here, it's also fully adjustable. Up here,
a hydraulic operated clutch, both levers are adjustable. All right, this is a V4. Doesn't quite sound like a V-twin or an inline four. Has kind of its own unique exhaust note. It doesn't like sound as good as like a Ducati, the new Ducati V4 or an Aprilia V4 or a VFR V4. I think it's because it's not a 90 degree V4 or 45. It's like a weird, they'll have like some kind of weird V angle, so they don't have that kind of noise. Okay, this bike is a heavyweight. It weighs 683 pounds, wet, has a 4-gallon gas tank, has 200 horsepower. By the way, the 4-gallon gas tank capacity, you really wish it had more than that, because it doesn't really get that good of gas mileage, so your range is very low. Wow, what is that? Vulture? Yeah, look at that. Big old vulture there. I don't see that every day. I think the seat height is around 30, 31 inches, but the seat is very wide. Shorter riders will definitely be challenged. Actually, one of the things I want to talk about is this a cruiser? Well, let me tell you, I think I can speak for myself, since I own one and I own cruisers, that this is definitely not a cruiser. This is like more like a naked bike. The dogs are out. There's the V-Rod. In my opinion, this is not a cruiser. It doesn't look like one. It doesn't sound like one. It doesn't feel like one. It feels like a naked bike. It sounds like, you know, like Yamaha has an MT-10. This should be like the MT-17. That's what this feels like. People complain about the scoops hitting their knees. It does, but it doesn't really bother me. It has almost a comforting feel to me. Oh, I really want to rip on it right now. This thing has a lot of power. It will definitely spin the tires in the lower gears. I've never felt like the front end was ever going to come up on me on this. It's not that hard to ride. So the power band, it's got a lot of power even off idle, but after it hits like 4,000, it just gets insane. And it revs up to like 10,000. It has a shift light too, by the way. I forgot to mention that. It has a shift light that you can adjust. You can adjust the state as a staging light, getting off the line, and as a shift light to tell you when to grab the next gear. You heard that, right? You heard the tire screech. Wow. This thing moves. I mean, I ride a ZX14R and this thing is scaring me. How fast it is. How powerful it is. Okay, one of the things that I really like about this, I mentioned that it has shaft drive. It doesn't really have that much of a shaft drive jacking, so some bikes have a lot of that. What that means is when you hit the gas, the front end will want to come up. If you let off the gas, if you're downshift, it'll go down. It'll actually jack up and down. It'll have like a reaction with the drive shaft. And this bike does not have has very little jacking motion. And I like that. My VFR, it's not as good as my VFR that I had, the 1200F. But it's a lot better than my M109R that I used to own. That thing had a lot of jacking motion. Even off the power band, it has more power than most cruisers. And by the way, this is not a cruiser. Wow, this thing really goes. This is fun. Like I said, even though it doesn't have as much power, it still has plenty of power. The Vmax has only 5 gears, by the way, not 6 gears. I wished it had it. It would definitely improve it, but there's a lot of bikes that don't
rev up that high on the highway. The cruising RPM, the gears are spaced not wide, but not super close.
It's not like the V-Rod. The V-Rod's like a motocross bike, man. The gears were spaced so close. This is definitely not that. You just can't give it full throttle in first. It'll just spin the tires. But the comfort's not horrible. The pegs are mid pegs. It's not a cruiser. They're basically straight down from the seat. The seat is not overly firm, but not too soft. The gas mileage sucks. I think we haven't got any exact figures yet. I got to get that for you guys. My daughter is the one that mostly rides this bike, not me. Because she was the one that she took over on the V-Rod, and then I traded in the V-Rod, so this was her bike. I'll have to get you some more information on that, but you know, you're talking pretty much less, you know, 100 miles range is about it, and probably not even if you're really aggressive on the throttle. So, oh yeah, as far as the engine smoothness, feels very smooth. There's a little bit of vibration through the handlebars, just a little teeny bit. Not much, not annoying at all. I don't see how it could even get annoying. It's not that buzzy annoying. I like the digital speedometer. Surprised it could keep up. How fast this thing is, how fast that back tire, or if I guess the front tire is measuring it from. I try to give it a little run here. It's like impossible. Wow. It's like impossible to, wow. It just could not even begin to keep the front tire, I mean keep the tire from spinning. It's got so much power. It needs more traction. But I'm thinking if it had any more. Okay, here we go for a roll on. Well, I'm doing 88 miles an hour, and it's almost 5,000 RPM. But you can imagine if I hit the throttle, it's gonna really rock it, because it's already in its power band. There we go. Just like that. Just like that. I didn't have to downshift or anything, so it's pretty powerful. Fly screen. And the wind is not that bad. Not that bad at all. The shoulders have a little bit more air, but I think that fly screen is doing a pretty decent job. I don't know where it came from. I don't even know if it came stock that way, or if that's a Yamaha option. That's the way I got the bike. I got the bike with 300 miles on it. And it came with that. It came with bar end mirrors, which I got rid of because I hate them. I hate bar end mirrors. Still got a ton of power. Wow. Ton of power. I imagine if you got into the ultra legal speeds, the factory's speed limiter will shut it down really fast.
was fun. That was a little hit on the highway. Wow. Oh, very nice. Except for, I guess it doesn't have a thermometer. I like having a thermometer. It doesn't have that. And as we get off the highway, I'm going to go get some gas. We'll show you how to put gas in this thing.
Okay, so if the fuel release is right here, just hit it like that, and there it goes. It pops open. Then you can get to the fuel tank. You got to release the fuel cap. Fill her up. There we go. It took 2.7 gallons to fill. When the fuel warning light comes on, that leaves 1.3 gallons in reserve. Total 4 gallons.
All right, so we're gassed up, ready to go. There we go. Starter has a very unique sound to it. Take about half throttle in first without spinning the tires if you do it gently. Suspension is stiff. Suspension feels stiff, and I have everything set at its lowest settings. So even with everything at the low, it's not that it's like punishing, it's just stiff. It's not like punishing me, like, but it's definitely on the stiff side. It's been fun. This bike has some definite pros and some definite cons. If I was just going to give you the quick pros about this bike, it has a menacing presence. It has a lot of street cred, man. It's a fast bike. It's a cool bike. Incredible acceleration. If it makes you feel better, call it a cruiser. I don't think it is one. The only styling cue it has, it's a cruiser, has kind of a duckbill rear, which I guess is, you know, kind of cruiserish. The cons, I might skip back and forth, but the cons is definitely the fuel range. It's just ridiculous. Consider that we just went out to do a vlog on it, and I had to fill it up with gas. So, you know, I'm not really riding this that much. My daughter rides it, and she doesn't really do long rides. But when we go on a big cruise, she has to let everybody know that she doesn't have the same fuel range as some of the other bikes out there. So, I don't know who would buy this bike. If you just want sheer power, without the front end, doing wheelies on you and flipping the bike, I really can't think of a faster bike than this, to be honest with you. Is there one?